Good morning, everybody. I'm sort of going to spend the next few minutes, hopefully, if nothing else, leaving you with one thought and one thought only. Now, today, 2018, March is the time to invest in Africa. First, I've got to do what is due, which is I'm here courtesy of the Africa Business Angel Network, which is the trade association in Africa for angel networks, set out to do three things, basically. First is to create angel networks. Second is to actually educate those angels so that they can become world-class investors. And third and final is to engage with our policymakers on the continent to ensure that they start treating angel investing with the respect it demands. Now, while we even having this conversation, just like you heard earlier, guess what? Africa is by and far the youngest continent we now have. So while people in the West are getting older, people in Africa are getting younger. Do that commercially in your head. So the context for me personally, as you heard, is technology, and it's the fact that we've gone from mainframes when I was growing up, where we'd fill a room like this with a mainframe, to today, where what I'm wearing on my wrist is just as powerful as an IBM 370 was in the day. So we're getting this miniaturization of technology that is happening. Software, okay, is becoming the ultimate consumer of the world. So when you look at what people are doing with software, it is phenomenal. And then especially more important for us is the fact that we've been talking crypto earlier. No, I'm surprised we haven't brought up the concept of drones, artificial intelligence, deep learning. There's a whole bunch of technology that is just happening. Candace, is, for example, earlier was talking about space. Technology is unstoppable. It is moving, and that's the context. But let me talk about Africa. First, if you look top left, I thought of, let this sink in. If I took all of United States, continental United States, add China, add India, if I fitted it into Africa, I'd still have space left to take Europe. That's how big Africa is. And I don't think quite a lot of people understand that. Just hear me again, United States, China, India, all their landmass together would fit into Africa and there'd still be space left. So thinking about Africa as one monolithic whole, yes, it is. We have the African Union. We've actually even got 8 regional, okay, associations that actually manage Africa, but there are 54 sovereign countries, each with its own leadership and government on the continent of Africa. Aside from that, there are 1.2 billion people on that continent. That's what we're talking about today. Now, what is Africa? This is Africa. We are culture. Everything we do breathes culture. Every ounce of our body, from when we wake up in the morning to when we go to bed at night, it's all about culture. Culture is about how things are done. From how you say good morning, it's not the same for everybody. Good morning to somebody older than you is different to good morning to somebody younger than you. That is the way Africa works. But what am I talking about? The narrative has changed. If I was standing here 15, 20 years ago, you'd remember that kid. You know, the starving kid with the big stomach asking for $5? Well, guess what? Today, the continent has moved on. A friend of mine shared pictures of some of the cities and people were flabbergasted. Why? Because Africa is a continent and it is about the cities. The cities are the gateway. Take my home city, Lagos. Lagos is a megalopolis. We're talking about 20 million people in one geography. You've got Joburg. You've got Lusaka. You've got Nairobi. I could go on and on. Oh, by the way, if you're wondering the difference between the black and the red, the black ones are the places I've physically been. The red ones are the ones I still want to go. And these are just the top 100 cities in Africa. So when we do talk about the continent, I just hope that sets the context, okay, of what I'm talking about. Why am I talking about it? Well, I did say it was going to be technology. Mobile connectivity. The mobile phone is the dominant technology platform on the continent, and it is growing gangbusters. Just a few days ago, my home city, my home country, Nigeria, 162 million mobile subscribers. Think about that as a market, and you start to understand the nature of what we're talking about here. We've got fiber surrounding the continent. However, don't get me wrong, okay? The middle class in Africa is really what this story is all about. We're seeing a near 7% year-on-year growth in GDP because of these people. And what is happening is the disposable income, yes, slightly negligible compared to Western world, but it is there and it is enough to be driving all kinds of change. Having said that, I'm not saying we're perfect. I'm not even saying it's ecstatic, because guess what? We do have challenges, and they are fundamental and they are serious. The biggest is urbanization. I just talked about Lagos. Lagos is expected to be one of the top five cities, population-wise, in the world within the next 15 years. We are seeing a drift from the villages into the cities like none other. Africa is currently the fastest urbanizing continent on the planet, bar none, even faster than China. In addition, you would have heard of our security problems. In my home country, Nigeria, it's called Boko Haram. You could go anywhere on the continent. There is a security risk. Energy is a significant challenge to us. But again, education. So I was enamored hearing about Latin America just a few minutes ago, where education is going through the roof. I wish I could say the same about the continent. Unfortunately, it's not true. We have a challenge with education. And in these challenges lie the opportunities I see for people like yourselves to invest in the continent. Because you solve problems, you make money. So what's happening with the ecosystem? We do have a thriving ecosystem on the continent. If you look, all the usual suspects, Yahoo, Google, Facebook, you name them, they're all there. They're starting to invest, they're starting to play a very, very live and active role. But at the same time, we have homegrown companies like MTN, Main One, Glo. These are behemoths in their own right too. I typically ask, and may I, you know, just one second, just by a show of hands, how many people here think that we have more than 100 companies on the continent making more than $1 billion a year? Guess what? There are 400 of them. Okay? 400 companies making more than $1 billion a year in revenue. Not in valuation, in revenue. That's what we're talking about here. So the early stage ecosystem on the continent over the last decade has started to grow, like everywhere else. Why? Because there are individuals who actually are putting money through what we call hubs. These are innovation spaces that you will find on the continent. There are, this number 400, they're actually 442 hubs, okay, on the continent. But the latest entrants being people like Facebook and, surprise, surprise, Google, who are following on from Barclays is missing on that list. There are quite a number of others who have put money through these different vehicles onto the continent. Having said that, all of us last year, all we could muster was $200 million, which is less than, somebody was telling me, half their fund. So that's why I'm standing in front of you today to share with you the fact that agritech is alive and well and doing well in Africa. Fintech was just mentioned. Barclays has spent a king's ransom looking at blockchain and other types, not Bitcoin, other types of technology associated with financial fintech. In fact, I dare say the largest single startup investment we had last year was $10 million going to Flutterwave, which is a payment settlement organization. There are innovations. We mentioned the Lagos Angel Network. What makes what we do there slightly unique is the fact that it's an ecosystem rather than a singular effort. And there are some lessons that have come out of the continent. We need to educate investors, but you need to start investing now. Because guess what? You can't learn from any mistakes you haven't made. So get in, make it fast. We're not getting any help from government. That's why I'm standing here also. And please, 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 whatever you do, if you're coming on the continent, find a local, all right, and co-invest with them. So I hope you found the last few minutes very useful. I'm going to be around for the next couple of days if you want to have a chat. Thank you very much for listening.
Ladies and gentlemen, Harry Tom Davies.